Over the coming weeks, we'll be speaking with political party leaders or a representative, and we ask them why Pacific people should vote for them. And joining me now for our first one is New Conservative Party Deputy Leader Elliot Ikilei. Elliot, thank you for joining us, brother.
Kia rāda. Whakarawhātu. So glad to be here.
It's awesome to have you here. And firstly, for those who don't know you, Elliot, just tell us a little bit about yourself, your background, where you've come from, and how you've ended up where you are as a Deputy Leader of the New Conservative Party. Yeah.
So, grew up in GI. I'm Niue, Tonga, Te Atiawa, Ngāti Raukawa, and English. Probably for the last 20 years, I've been in youth work, and that's dealing with youth suicide and sexual slavery, and all the way up to building programs for resilience and training. Been a wonderful time, and I joined politics basically because I've seen what's happening to our families and all the young people on the streets.
Yeah. What does the New Conservative Party stand for? What are the values, what are the morals that you guys have? What do you campaign on in this?
Well, situation? New Conservative is very much a conservative party, so we do campaign and we fight for probably what you'd refer to as Western culture, Western values. And that, of course, is the combination of Greek democracy combining with the Judeo-Christian principles and ethics. So we're very much about what works. We're very much about individualism and the rights of the people and the lives of the people, which is why, for example, we're quite strongly pro-life, as an example.
So let's talk about some of those of where you stand on some issues. So homosexuality is one, and I've seen you've been quite vocal on social media. You've got quite a large following there. Tell us about where you stand in terms of homosexuality.
Well, homosexuality is someone's psychological reaction to a whole raft of different areas. In terms of homosexuality, we don't actually have much to say about it. What we do say is that the best place for a young person to be raised with being resilient, choosing good things, is in a married mum and dad home. Mm-hmm. So we're very much focused on that. One of the things that we are proud of is that we were the team who were able to expose to the public and the parents that gender ideology is being pushed onto our children. We were able to expose it by forcing the government to give us the facilitators' handbooks. We handed that out, and wonderfully, quite a few schools have already started to question, to have questioned by the parents this program, and now they're stopping this program. And that's a wonderful thing because we don't hide things, we give it out to the parents, and they make their own choice.
This election, we're having a couple of referendums,
yes.
Cannabis and the end of life choice bill. Where does your party sit on this?
Quite easy. For myself and many of our candidates, we've worked on the front line with young people who are struggling with a whole bunch of issues. If you engage in THC, which is the psychoactive part of cannabis, you will see it becoming a gateway drug. Our at-risk families will become more at risk, it will grow out. They will then prey upon those others for that money to gain it. We've seen it time and time again, and overseas what we see is that they make the drug stronger, heavier and harder. Mm-hmm. And so we absolutely know on that. In terms of life, we believe that life is a sacred thing, that there is always hope. We do know that overseas, every single time that they've introduced the suicide aspect, the assisted suicide, basically it expands out. Currently in the Dutch lawmakers, for example, are trying to push through the idea that a person 75 years older can kill themselves using euthanasia laws, and not unhealthy or anything like that, just simply if they want to. So we believe that life is sacred and that people will be strong and weak at different points in their life, and we fight to protect that life from womb to the tomb.
And in terms of issues for Pacific people, what are the major ones that you see? Every election year we seem to talk about housing. We seem to talk about poverty. What are the big issues you think that Pacific people face this coming election?
Well, the big one obviously is economic, and that's for all people. Mm-hmm. But I think there's a larger one at stake. And what we've seen is that, I think, and this is quite an exciting thing, is that Labor for the last 35 years has used and manipulated Pacifica people as a group, just like a vote plantation. Now that's starting to finally change. So some of the most anti-Pacifica values and the anti-traditional values that they come from is being pushed out there by Labor. Now we're starting to find that that's starting to change. If we can change that, then we can protect true Pacifica values and where we come from, our heritage. One of the big ones, of course, is abortion. Abortion, New Zealand now has the most brutal abortion law in the Western culture. Mm. And that was pushed, almost every Labor Pacifica MP pushed for that as well. And that it is a horrendous bill. And so we are those who stand there. So I think there is a deeper value. Economics, housing, that's there. Mm-hmm. But more importantly, beneath that are the very values and the ideologies that we have come from and that we have built upon. And that's what we're saying is actually the real big one this year. This year, this election will be more important than every other election in the history of New Zealand. Going back before Savage and Muldoon, going back to 1852 Constitution Act, this is the big one. This is the watershed one that students in the future will be looking at towards. And Pasifika have a wonderful opportunity to finally take away from Labour's usage of us as a float plantation.
So do you think Labour's sort of taken for granted that Pacific vote?
Not just taken for granted, they've manipulated and abused us. Because when you look at the policies that they've pushed forward, they are policies and views that are absolutely against our traditional values. Not just meandering along the way, but actually against our ones. We love life, but this particular government has been fighting hard to kill off babies, and to, even on the other side, introduce suicide as a taxpayer-funded and a healthcare-facilitated event.
Food for thought there, Elliot. We've got to leave it there. Could keep yarning to you for a few more hours, I suppose, but we've got to leave
no
it there.
Problem.
Thank you for joining us, Elliot Ikilei, Deputy Leader for the New Conservative Party.
Thank you so much.